Good morning, everyone. We want to welcome you to another, it's usually a science demonstration, but this morning we have a nature demonstration entitled Growing Trees. So if you would like to open that, call it a nature demonstration, and it's based on Genesis 2:9. So let's open our Bibles. I hope you brought your Bibles, Genesis 2:9, and I suppose I should read it because I'm hooked up to the mic. But we'll get others involved soon. And out of the ground made the Lord God to grow every tree, and I want you to listen to the reasons why he made it to grow. Every tree that is pleasant to the sight and good for food, the tree of life also in the midst of the garden, and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. That's Genesis 2:9. So I need some help here. What are some of the reasons God put trees in the Garden of Eden? Ashley, she has her hand.
Pleasant for sight.
Pleasant for sight. Anybody remember anything else that we read? It's good for food. There it is up there. Now, I don't know if you're like me, but you like to be out in the forest, in the woods, going for a walk, looking at the trees. So my question for Ashley and Benjamin and Tamla is, what is your favorite tree? God said they're to be pleasant to our sight. So does any particular tree come to mind, Ashley?
A maple tree.
Why do you like
maple? I like the maple leaf.
She likes the design of the maple leaf. But there are several designs, but the one we have at home are the sugar maples, and they have a nice leaf. Okay. Any tree come to mind on this side?
Palm tree is my favorite. Do you find it at the beach?
Yes. You like palm trees. That's nice. I'm going to have some pictures of that soon. I don't know. We might have a maple. Tamala?
I like oak trees.
Oak trees?
Yes.
Okay, if we had time, I'd find out why you like palm and oak. Ashley's already told us she likes the design of the leaf. Let's go to another slide, slide 3. Do you know what tree this is? We don't have that tree around here. That's why it might look puzzling to you. The next slide tells you it's a eucalyptus tree.
Where koalas eat.
Koalas love eucalyptus trees. And here is another one with a different color blossom. But those are eucalyptus. Those two slides are eucalyptus trees. And what do you think this is? Next slide.
Coconut.
Okay, I heard Benjamin say something.
Oh.
A palm. Ashley says palm. Tamla says coconut. Well, it's a coconut tree. And you know, it didn't look like a coconut tree to me, either Benjamin or Ashley. But that's sort of like it's a palm, but it's not a date palm. It's a coconut tree. What about this one?
Peach.
Ashley knows. She saw this slide before, but you can tell by looking. It's a peach tree. This tree, and I put this in because we have here in West Virginia Logan State Park. This supposedly is Chief Logan's elm tree, where under this elm tree, and of course this occurred in the late 1700s, he gave his famous speech. And here's this, let me tell you a little bit about it since we're here in West Virginia. According to an account by Thomas Jefferson, white settlers were outraged by robberies committed by Indians, American Indians, Native Americans, and in retaliation killed many innocent Native Americans, including the family of Logan, chief of the Mingo Indians, who was known as a friend of the whites. Led by Logan, the Indians fought back. This was in 1774. After losing, next slide, Chief Logan sent the following speech to Lord Dunmore, Governor of Virginia. I may have told you this in a story, so if you've heard this before. Anyway, it's a speech that in the 1800s, children read in school, and they might have memorized it. They were very familiar with this speech, and Kennedy quoted him. Part of this when he came to West Virginia campaigning for the presidency. And I don't know if we should take time to read it, but it's a good, I'll read the first part. Chief Logan said to Governor Dunmore of Virginia, I appeal to any white man to say, if ever he entered Logan's cabin hungry, and he gave him not meat, if ever he came cold and naked, and he clothed him not. During the course of the last long and bloody war, Logan remained idle. This is Logan speaking, but he's speaking in third person. Logan remained idle in his cabin, an advocate for peace. Such was my love for the whites that my countrymen pointed as they passed and said, Logan is the friend of white men. I had even thought to have lived with you, but for the injuries of one man, Colonel Cresap, the last spring, in cold blood and unprovoked, murdered all the relations of Logan, not even sparing my women and children. And he goes on to say, at the end, who is there to mourn for Logan? Not one. They were all gone because of this strife between Native Americans and white men. Anyway, that was the elm tree under which he gave this speech. Next slide. Looks to me like it might be maple trees. Ashley, for you. Next slide. Pine trees. A lot of people like pine trees.
Oh, lower spruces.
15. Slide 15. We don't have these trees here, so you may not recognize this, but this is an old olive tree growing in Italy. We're going to move on. Next slide. Probably all of you recognize the... Yes, that's your favorite pastor. Okay, now we've seen pastor's favorite. Now, for this little nature demonstration, and it's really not going to be real nature. Now, next slide tells you what we need. And you're going to need to gather around this end of, well, stay close to this part of the table. We just need newspaper, scissors, maybe rubber bands. And we're going to stop there and move over. What we have here are newspapers. Now, you're familiar with newspaper. You open it up, you read it. And what we need to do for this demonstration is cut a page in half. Like, here's a page of newspaper. So what I'm going to do is take a pair of these scissors and cut it in half. That's the first step. And you need, I put on the slide about 15 sheets of these, but I have found that 7 or 8 does it, because you'll see that we have to, if you move that body, and each of you will need to paste this, not yet though, let me keep the scissors right here. You need one of these, and one of these, and I'll show you what I mean. We need one of these, a tube, an empty tube, paper towel tube, and I'm going to give Benjamin and Ashley each about 7, 8, see how many there are there, Benjamin. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have enough to do 8. Now, what we have to do is roll our paper. Now, I'm going to show you how to do that, because we don't roll them all at once. We take one, you know, and just roll it. Roll it till you get to the halfway mark. See where the halfway mark is? Roll it on your, and then take another piece and fit it in there. And keep rolling. We're going to make one long piece till you get to the halfway mark. And bring your tube back. And roll it in to the halfway mark. Get another piece of paper. And you can do about 7 or 8 of these, even up to 15, but 15 makes it a little harder to do the next step. And I think I'm going to. So for the last page, you just roll all the way down. I think that's enough for me. And then, when we get to the end, we have this one flap of paper. We're going to have to tape it down. So, and to help you tape it, you could put a rubber band, if you were all by yourself, put a rubber band around it while you tape. Or you might have a helper. Here you go.
Just like this?
Oh, no, you want to hold that So that's right. Get another piece here and another piece there. So once you have it taped, then you pull out your tube. You don't need it anymore.
You haven't had yours taped.
No, I have to.
You'll have to tape that right there.
No, no. It's just to hold it so it doesn't get in your way while we do the next step. So now we have a rolled tube of newspaper.
I don't know if I can get mine out.
Okay, you just kind of push. All right. Well, then if you can't.
Maybe I did it too tight.
You might have. But we will solve this. We are scientists. We will think this through. That's good. I'm going to get it out. You got yours out. Great, Benjamin. Now, the next step is everybody needs a pair of scissors. And don't do anything yet. You can use mine.
No, I think he's getting it.
Okay, great. Now, I've done the next step. The next step is we're going to make some leaves on our tree. And to do that, you're going to cut halfway down, maybe 4 or 5 times around. And see, that's why you don't want to use 15 sheets of paper, because it's a little hard to cut halfway down through this thickness. But it would be fun to use many more sheets of paper and just...
I could use colored paper and you could also put colored paper.
Oh, that's a good idea, Ashley. Maybe next time. She says we could make a colorful tree. Now, so we cut down halfway.
Is that halfway?
Some more. Yes, that's right. You don't have to be extremely exact. I think I'll do one more in mine. Okay, now we have our tree. See?
You have your tree.
Okay, I'll wait. What I want you to do is open it up like this so that you can look down.
Once I get that far.
Okay. Is it hard to cut? I think we'll do this for Samantha later on. She probably would like this. Okay. One more probably would. Oh, Benjamin's going to have lots of branches. That's good, Benjamin. Now you kind of open it up so you can get to the center and look down. See? Because the next step is we're going to make our tree. And I'll show you on this one and we'll... You take the inside and just start pulling. Just keep pulling. There you go. It might grow to be 6 feet tall. Who knows? See how tall your tree will come. Oops. That tore. We are growing trees. Now, it's not really a science demonstration, nor a true nature demonstration, because only God can grow trees.
I thought it was a tree.
Well, let's see if how many rolled pieces of paper?
7.
If we had used more paper, we would have a gigantic tree.
Call it Benjamin.
Yes. Okay. There is my tree. Tamala, you want to try and grow a tree? We have an extra one here. Okay.
Thank you.
Yes. Now, if we go back to our slide show, we realize that this verse that we just read tells us that trees are to be pleasant. God made them so that they are pleasant to look at and that they provide food for us. But there are other things. So on slide 19, trees are useful to build things, build homes, build furniture. We get other products from trees, like this newspaper. This paper pulp comes from trees. We also get rubber from trees. We get medicines from trees. Do you know that quinine that is used to treat malaria comes from a tree bark? Eucalyptus oil we use. Trees also prevent erosion by wind and water. They maintain our atmosphere. I'm going to have to move on. And we just made paper trees. But slide 21, only God can make a tree. Here are sequoias, Pastor, in slide 22, Pastor's favorite tree in the wintertime. Slide 23, this is a 1,000-year-old plus tree. It's a bristlecone pine. It's the oldest tree we have on our planet. They can be, people say, 4,000 plus years old. You can see part of it has died, but part of it continues to live. That's a bristlecone pine. Well, that ends our little science demonstration, our nature demonstration. Only God can make a tree. We try to make something similar, and it's pretty laughable compared to what God can do. God makes the trees, and He makes them pleasant for us to enjoy and to give us food and to help our atmosphere, medicines, to build with. I'll remember the sanctuary. What was underneath the gold a lot of the times was wood. Okay, thank you for joining us for our little nature demonstration. Hope to see you next time.